Bleach Animation News. When are we going to get the trailer for season 2? Is there going to be a Bleach game on the horizon? And is the animation going to be better than Core 1? We're going to be discussing this all in this video, so stick around. Now, over the past 3 months, I really haven't been doing any videos because I haven't found anything significant enough in the Bleach news space to really cover. So we're going to have all this video in regards to all of those things that I might have opinions on and things that you may or may not like to know, especially on the Bleach game front. So with that being said, I asked some of you guys what you'd like me to cover, and here are some of the few things not in order that I thought were relevant to talk about. And no, I don't know anything about the Burn the Witch anime or manga coming out anytime soon, but hopefully, you know, we get to see Nini and Noelle yet again. And also, I'm not really interested in leaking the anime as much as I used to back in the day, because I kind of gave up on that, but I'll give some things here and there. First and foremost, when is the Bleach animation trailer? I don't have that answer for you. I'm not the studio nor the production committee. However, I can tell you usually about how these trailers go about. Do I think it's going to be at Anime Japan? Not really, but we'll talk about that anyway. But the rule of thumb when it comes to anime trailers is that usually you get a new anime trailer a month or some change before the actual airing of the series itself. This is what I said about Bleach Core 1, and those things seem to have happened. In fact, we got about 4. And the fact that it doesn't really have a stage at Anime Japan goes to tell me that they're not ready to really release anything. That's not to say it's not going to be at Anime Japan, which we'll talk about right now, is that yes, Aniplex does have a booth for the Bleach animation, which will be giving away merchandise, as well as repeating the PV of the one that we've all seen for Core 2, probably on screens. I don't feel like there's going to be much to be announced. However, Kubo did say on his Club Outside that there was going to be an announcement of something, whether that something is going to be at Anime Japan, or maybe it was something entirely different that we've already seen. Who knows? But for my expectations, I always tell you guys to keep it low. And I think, you know, they're just going to rebroadcast the PV at the exposition. We're going to get some merchandise. And it's just going to be a nice little booth for Bleach for people to go check out. And I think that's the purpose of the whole event in terms for Bleach's IP. The next question that I often get as well is, was Bleach successful? And this is a very difficult question to answer because there's a lot of fundamentals that go into a question like this, especially to answer it literally after the season had aired, because you don't really have data to figure until usually about 3 months after the airing itself, and of course with Blu-rays, especially with Disney buying the IP rights, which is going to make that fiscal reporting or even success rate even more harder, as they usually don't make that public. However, of course, as my opinion stands, I will say yes, it was very successful. I think anyone can see that it was in fact successful. So with that being said, how do we garner whether it was successful or not? And I think some of us can see that through social media marketing and, you know, merchandise promotions, Aniplex having their booth at Anime Japan. But I'll give you something a little bit more solid to work with. I mean, quite recently we saw the Blu-ray box sets for the original Bleach and also the new Bleach Thousand Year Blood War Blu-rays going on sale on Amazon, and the one for Thousand Year Blood War anime going on Amazon was completely sold out, and this was the exclusive edition of the special edition. So this is where you could pre-order off Amazon and you get like a Amazon exclusive pre-order for the Bleach thing, and yada yada yada, you know, you get something, and it basically, the reservations got pretty much sold out. So I think that in and of itself is quite telling and very exciting. Of course, you can see it on screen. So will it beat Chainsaw Man's 1,700 something sales? It's plausible. And I think it really is impressive as well. And I think Burn the Witch did somewhat similar numbers. I think it did about 2,000 for its special edition. Is that, you know, the special editions for these box sets are quite expensive. We're talking in pounds or US dollars. We're talking in the 200s to $300 or pounds margin here. So they're not cheap box sets at all. So to even have it, you know, even 1,000 is quite impressive in and of itself. Now, I hate to bring Chainsaw Man into this, but in comparison, Chainsaw Man's box set was extremely basic, and obviously Bleach's has got a special edition. So if that can sell out pretty well and even beat Chainsaw Man, I think that really speaks volumes about the fan base, or maybe the interest within the series of itself, or maybe it could just be an entirely different age demographic of people that are buying these things. But again, we have to wait and see to see what those sales say much later on down the pitch, maybe a few months time. So we're going to have to give it time. However, I will give you something a bit more concrete, and that is TV Tokyo's fiscal reports. Now, this isn't the quarterly reports that we usually get with the whole like little table box of series that was in the top 5. This is something a little bit more on the premature side of things, so take that as you will. But this was in one of the reports. Of course, I'll have the screenshot on screen so you can read it in full, but I'm just going to read out this particular portion. And yes, we're going to be talking about the Bleach game right after this as well, because You'll see. In the anime division, the mainstay of this segment, the new Bleach series enjoyed a strong distribution in China, Europe, and the US, and the sales increased due to game rights worldwide and merchandising in Europe and in the US. And yes, this is the only time Bleach is mentioned in this report, is that this is very interesting because you have two impactful-ish sentences here. Is that one, Bleach did well because of China, Europe, and US, which is expected, you know, basically the whole world in essence, almost. It had a strong buy-in. It's obviously notable to put into the fiscal report itself. So, you know, it didn't do mid or anything like that. It was significant enough to put and report on, because obviously you wouldn't put something that did poorly to an investor pool. But something else that was interesting was the second addition to that sentence, which was talking about the increase in sales due to game rights. And these game rights go to the US and Europe. Now, of course, everyone's thinking automatically, BBS, Bleach, Brave Souls, the mobile game. No, you wouldn't give game rights to the US or Europe when K-Lab have the rights and K-Lab themselves distribute Bleach Brave Souls over in the US and Europe on their own anyway, and they've been doing that for years, right? And the reason I held back on doing this video as a dedicated video was because of the choice of wording, and I wanted to see where this went. But fundamentally, and please tell me in the comment section down below, is that what this is saying is that game rights have been sold in the US and in Europe. First thing that comes to mind is a US games company, probably Bandai Namco. We don't really know until we can see. But quite recently, it seems that game rights were in fact sold, or rights were sold, which means that a Bleach game is in the works. And we've been knowing this for a while, because I think I've said multiple times in videos, and if not Twitter as well, that yes, a Bleach game is in the works somewhere, or at the very limited moment, is that it is exactly been talked about, and this report exactly proves that concept. Because again, if you want to talk about Bleach Brave Souls, it's been in the US and it's been in Europe for ages. The rights go to K-Lab. It's not like they do subsidiary rights that, like, oh, here you go, Bandai, do you want to be able to share your servers so people can play BBS? No, none of that. This is game rights being sold, and someone bought it. So not only is Disney buying, obviously, the anime, big thing for the anime, and I hope we get some numbers on that, but also on the game rights front as well. So I think many people are going to be excited for that. I think many people are pumped, and just let time do its process. But as I said, the screenshot is on screen, so interpret it how you will and have a nice little discussion. Let's talk about High Animation or Sakuga. Is Bleach Season 2 going to be looking better than Bleach Season 1? I think I can say this because I think it is vague. If you were to watch the original Bleach pre-animated preview, and of course the one that came out for Season 2, you will notice a lot of red sky, and we were kind of assuming that this was an aesthetic choice based off of, you know, the pink in Bleach Core 1. However, it would seem that this holds some significant ground, as red is going to be used as the background sky. Now, of course, I know a lot of you are probably like a bit wary on that. Don't think of it as like Bleach Brave Souls opening 2 type of red, or don't think about Persona 4 type of red. I think this is going to have an interesting contrast between the blue Von Donnerike and then obviously the red sky. I think the contrast is going to genuinely work well. And here's somewhat of an image to prove it. I'm not saying this person is on the series or not, unconfirmed, don't really know. I'm not going to say anything so I don't get in trouble. But here's an idea of how something like this could look. And if it somewhat looks like this in concept, I have not a problem with it at all. And to be honest with you, the different color types that we experienced in Season 1, I have not been disappointed, to be honest with you. Yeah, the pink is a bit, you know, for flashbacks. But other than that, I think it looks fantastic. And I think this is really going to fit the mood, and I'm excited. People are asking me about Yamashita. I don't know if Yamashita is coming back to the anime at all. I would imagine maybe he is. He wasn't really involved in the new Boruto Code arc that much, if at all, in fact. So it's possible that Yamashita can work on Bleach or have an involvement with Bleach. I don't see why he wouldn't, but it seems that he's been kind of quiet lately. So, you know, fingers crossed on that. And I won't say any more because I don't want to get anyone's expectations or hopes up. Another interesting thing is that Bleach has been having rebroadcasts at the start of April. This will be taking over Boruto's time slot. The irony, considering that Rock Lee took over Bleach's time slot when that ended. So fate is a good meme, I guess you could say. But I think it's also good as well. I do find it interesting how they're going to censor Bleach at a 5:30 p.m. time slot. But hey, it doesn't matter because we've got the uncensored version anyway. So I think this will bring a lot more eyes, especially to a younger generation as well. So again, I see that as a plus, and I think this was a very smart move on Pierro or TV Tokyo as this part. Depends on whoever's decision it was. And I think if it did successful at midnight, I feel like they're trying to replicate that again by trying to make it successful in the daytime as well. Which I think is one of those things where it's not like, it's not a solidified piece of evidence, but it's a suggestive piece of evidence that Bleach did successful, the fact that they're rebroadcasting it. So that's exciting as well. And this one's going to be brief to end off the video. Their Lolotto and Giselle's appearances or their voice lines have been recorded, and apparently Kubo is really impressed by them. I'm very excited to see and hear what they're going to be sounding like, what their mannerisms are going to be like. I think it's going to be really interesting for me. There's also potentially going to be new characters because Kubo said that he's been drawing new characters for Core 2, so that's kind of interesting. Well, it suggested that the new characters and character designs, so that's interesting to see where that's going to be leading. And considering we have a new fight involved as well within Core 2, if you didn't watch my last video from 3 months ago, I don't really have any thoughts on that. New characters, apparently, whether they're going to be background characters or lore related characters, who knows? Or maybe they're going to be, I don't know. Maybe it's set up for like Core 3. That's possible. Who knows? It could be light novel stuff. Like little sprinklings of foreshadowings for like light novels to come. Potentially. We don't know. And I'll leave it off with an unreleased volume cover. And I'll put up the screenshot of what Kubo said about it. But essentially, I assume Shueisha reached out to Kubo, said that they want to release Volume 1 as a special commemorative thing for like the anime returning. Kubo did multiple drafts, apparently, or multiple concepts. And the guy that was in charge of the project, he just didn't get along with. Where have we heard that story before, Kubo? I feel like Shueisha should just let Kubo do what he needs to do. But in this case, it seems that those two didn't get along well. And the Volume 1 cover that you see on screen wasn't going to get, you know, released at all. I think it's sick, personally. I think it looks really cool. But realistically, I mean, it can still come out. He said he's not going to do any more work on this volume cover. So it's quite plausible that Shueisha should just say, yeah, we'll have it. Fuck it, you know. But other than that, I think that sucks. That's a shame because we could have seen an increase in volume sales. But people do bring up the manga sales quite a bit as well. But you have to remember the context between the Bleach manga sales is not an indicator to whether the Bleach anime did well. Because Bleach, I think even 6 months to even a year before Bleach even came out with its anime, is that Bleach was able to be read for free and still is able to read for free on most Japanese book websites, some of those being ZBrek, for example. So I feel like the marketing approach is more so get Bleach out there, get a fandom out there, captivate as many people as you can to get them into the Bleach anime when it comes out, to catch people up, more so than focusing on manga sales. And I think like they're doing more well on probably merchandising than the manga sales currently. And I think the manga sales can come later on, but I wouldn't worry about the Bleach manga sales not having an increase or a push or a boost, because to be honest with you, Bleach can be read everywhere for free in the Japanese region. So I wouldn't be too bummed out about it. There's always context there. Don't let people on Twitter tell you otherwise. Other than that, I am going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine Debbie Hansen. I'm going away for 2 weeks to Japan. So if I come back and there's something new, I'll let you all know. And if there's something that happens at Anime Japan, if I don't make a video, you know why. But I'll try my best. Other than that, catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine Debbie Hansen. As always, people, peace out.